Hey guys, welcome to Motion Nerds, and in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how I made this hand animation in After Effects without using any third-party plugin. So let's begin. My source of inspiration was this piece called The Minima Manifesto by Ordinary Folks, and it's an amazing piece. Starting with the colors, the textures, and the overall look and feel of the piece is so good. You can actually go to their website and dig deep inside this project and see all the concept arts and the style frames for this piece and get an idea. What caught my attention was the hand animation towards the end, and I knew it in that moment that I had to recreate that in sort of my own style or something similar like that. So with that, I made a rough sketch of a hand, and as you can see, it's not that pretty looking, but it gets the job done. Then I took it to Illustrator and started building the hand. I actually break the hand in different parts so I can animate them individually. One important part was the joints of the fingers. As you can see, I made sure they all are perfect circles, so when I animate them in After Effects, I don't get any weird part poking out of the fingers or something like that. In After Effects, I imported the Illustrator file and started pre-comping them into their own compositions. After that, I reposition their anchor points so I can rotate them from where they need to be rotated. Once everything was set up, I started animating the layers. As you can see, it's just simple positioning and rotation keyframes. Nothing fancy. I didn't do anything crazy, any weird expression or anything like that. Just simple parenting and keyframes. At this stage, I also added a switch so the finger can push the switch around. I made sure there is a nice rhythm to the animation. I started playing with the positions of the keyframes, moving them around, and after that I adjusted the speed graph to make the animation look more natural and fluid. One important thing to note here that I made sure everything moves in an arcing motion so that the animation looks more nice and natural. Also, I want to know what methods you guys use for animating these kind of scenes. Do you guys use plugins like Duik or Limber or something else? I really want to know, so comment down below. For texturing the hand, I imported an image sequence which I made like ages ago and started playing with it. I animated its scale and rotation, also added a warp distortion effect to make it bend to follow the shape of the finger. After that, I used the Preserve Underlying Transparency button to add the texture to the finger. I duplicated the texture a couple more times and stacked them one over another to get that look. I also end up adding a shape layer stroke with the roughened edges effect to get sort of like a highlight effect on each of the fingers. And I basically did that for all of the fingers. One important thing I did was I added a mask to the base of each and every part of the finger. So when they merge in the final composition, they merge naturally without any weird seams poking around here and there when you're like basically rotating them. When it comes to the background, the first thing I did was add in gradient ramp and adjusted their color and position till I was happy with it. After that, I imported another grungy texture image sequence and started playing with different color and blending mode to see what looks good. I duplicated the same texture and repositioned them with different scale values into their own pre-composition and use the color dodge blending mode to blend it with the main background. For the switch, I used the gradient ramp and adjusted their color and position. I also duplicated the layer to create a subtle shadow and finally finished it off with some roughened edges effect to add some extra details around the edges. After this, I used a solid layer with mask to create a stylish lens flare and animate that using just some rotation and opacity keyframes. I also added some glow when the finger touched the switch, and that was just achieved with a solid layer with the add blending mode and some opacity keyframes. At this point, I was happy with the background, but I still wanted to add some more elements to it. So I added a solid layer with a gradient ramp, linear wipe, Venetian blight, roughen edges. I also blurred this circle a bit so it can blend with the background a bit more. I duplicated this layer and scattered them all around the comb with different opacity level to make the comb look more dynamic. For the final look, I added a roughened edges to the entire hand composition so it doesn't look too smooth around the edges. I also added a vignette around the edges to draw the focus more to the center. And finally finish it off with a bit of noise to get that grainy look. And finally a posterized time effect set to 12 fps to achieve that low frame rate hand drawn look. And that's it, that's how I created this entire piece. I know there's a lot to take in, but I wanted to go through the entire process of making this piece. Thank you guys for watching this video. I really hope you learned something new from these techniques. If you guys have any questions regarding this tutorial, please comment down below and I will try to answer them all. You can also leave a like if this benefited you and share it with more people so they can learn these techniques too. And finally, subscribe for more tutorials and I'll be seeing you in the next one.